He's on another good lap here, isn't he, the Martinator? He'll drop down now through the spectacular turn seven. You'll get proper wheel spin there in the Grand Prix tomorrow. He's lost it there. Just a little mistake, so he's backed out of this one, Martin. Look at Pedro Acosta. Pedro Acosta on a flyer as well. This is coming through seven then.
He's had a scare there. It was hard to feel. See, but obviously he felt it. Sorry if I was blind to that one, but I imagine one of the tyres has let go, and I missed which one it was.
Here comes
Ollie.
He didn't. He had to quickly roll out of it. Oliveira up to second, 119.471. Trackhouse Racing have two riders at the moment on the front row of the grid here in Germany.
He couldn't get it stopped there, so the next lap's not coming.
Now then, here comes Pedro Acosta. He was super rapid in the first half of that current lap. Finds himself in ninth place. That's at the back of row three. He'd certainly been hoping for better than that. Vinales had a strong first sector as we pick up Fabio de Gianantonio. Properly riding through the pain barrier here, isn't he? Digia flicks it left through the Queckenberg corner. This is turn 13, final corner here in the Sachsenring ring. Over the blind crest, short run then now to the finish line. Gianantonio, P8, he's found himself in the 119s as well. Right now, Maverick.
That looks big.
Maverick's had a big one. He crawls away from the scene. That ain't still running, that, isn't it? You can see the rear tyre still spinning around. Now, Vinales had a crash this morning in FP2 at turn one. A relatively slow tip-off. That one has properly hurt Maverick Vinales. He's dropped back onto his knees again. Turn 10, Simon. Building speed through those left-handers before you flick it right.
My guess is lose the rear there because you accelerate between the turns. And if you lose the rear, that looks like he's got flicked over the top.
Well, he was crawling away, then he got to his feet quickly. Now, thankfully, he's going to very gingerly get back on his feet. How many monster crashes have we had so far this weekend? There's his teammate looking rather concerned. Alexis Fargo, who's sidelined this weekend of his last lap crash in the sprint 1 week ago. Yellow flags, of course, now are out.
Just for the viewers, smoke coming out of the exhaust is oil running out of the engine breather into the airbox, and then the engine eating that oil. It's not the engine broken, and the machine runs until a certain point so the rider can pick it up, but when it's going to do damage, for example, it stopped picking up oil, the engine knows and cuts it off, or the electronics do, and rescues the engine because they need to keep them for the next races.
Martin's gone off-roading at turn one as he looked to push on to improve on that 119.42. We saw by now, this is the replay of Vinales.
Rear.
Big crash. Another huge crash. Yesterday, we saw monster crashes for Marc Marquez, Bezzecchi, and Andrea Bastianini. That's a
full rodeo, isn't it?
Oh, proper slams down onto his lower back. No wonder he was just trying to catch his breath trackside there. Look at this. Fourth gear, just under 150 kilometres now. He just started to tap the power back in. Yep. That rear tyre just started to spin up underneath him.
That's a nice new tyre, not fully up to temperature, Matt. And that's what I guess, right on the edge of it.
There's a few riders, Simon, are going to be happy. We do go into a three-week summer break after this German Grand Prix. They're in recovery mode because there's a lot of beaten up riders going into the sprint and Grand Prix here in Germany tomorrow.
My gut feeling is Maverick got away with that, Matt. He's going to be all right, you know, meaning for the sprint for,
What about this from Raul Fernandez? Martin's made a couple of mistakes on successive laps. It's not damaged his hopes as it stands right now of a 17th MotoGP pole position. Raul Fernandez has just lost a bit of time though. Now he's decided to roll out of it. Did he make a mistake in turn 7 or 8? So let's try and catch our breath. Martin on course for pole position. Trackhouse Racing's Oliveira and Fernandez on the front row. Dream scenario for the Trackhouse duo. Bagnaia at the moment in fourth place. Alex Marquez fifth. Morbidelli will be inside the top six. Acosta's off the front three rows now in 10th place. Binder 11th. Bezzecchi in 12th place. So it's all on Bagnaia then if he is to make it three poles in a row here in Germany. We follow Acosta. And this won't be good enough. And he's going to take the checkered flag imminently. So Pedro Acosta He's going to find himself on row four. Just the one row ahead of Marc Marquez, who missed out on a place in this second qualifying session. Looks like at the moment it's going the way of Martin. Bagnaia looks like he might well be the only rider capable of denying him here late on. Down we go through the fast fourth gear, turn seven. Alex Marquez now, another rider that's taken a tumble. Now, is this going to compromise Pecco Bagnaia's hopes? Because for the yellow flags of quickly kick, yeah, Bagnaia's had to back out of it once again. Where did Alex Marquez go down then? So there was a lot of yellow flag drama there for Pecco Bagnaia. Twice he had to roll out of it on good laps.
On the second row, and look at David Abbrivio, Trekhouse Racing's new team manager. How exciting is that? Second, both riders on the front row, man.
Trekhouse Racing must be pinching themselves. Dreamland here in Germany. Crikey. Sorry if we just jumped out of our skins here, because part of our commentary box is starting to fall to pieces.
Didn't get hit, but it was close.
No, we didn't get hit, yeah. Commentators okay, I think, is the graphic we need to put up on the screen.
This is a good moment, I think, to say I listened to Justin Marks for the first time in an interview with Mugello, and I wasn't sure what to expect. You know, someone coming from NASCAR racing in the US, and what a pleasure to listen to. He was humble, intelligent, and exactly what I thought, the sort of guy behind the team to make this work.
What a weekend so far it's been for Trekhouse Racing. Both their riders starting on the front row of the grid here in the Grand Prix of Germany. Let's get some thoughts from, I'm sure, absolutely thrilled team boss Davide Abbrivio.
Yeah, he was just asking for directions down to Parc Fermé. It's been a while, Davide. Second and third. What a brilliant performance from your guys.
Yeah, I'm not used to see where is the Parc Fermé. So. Yeah, no, it's great. I mean, of course, it's just the qualifying, but looks like we are in a good shape. And also, Miguel was fast this morning, all the weekend, and great, great first row. And also Raul recovered from Q1, 19 twice. So we are in, okay, now let's try to race. And maybe the sprint, we try to set up as much as possible, maybe for tomorrow, but okay, let's go racing and see what's happened.
Go and enjoy it. Well done.
Thank you.